That is the key, Tom Foreman. Thank you. Let's get more now with Amit Yoran, who used to work with the Department of Homeland Security and is now the CEO of Tenable. Amit, good to see you this morning. I mean, that is a good point there from our Tom Foreman. This worldwide tech crash happened from a single software update, from a single cybersecurity company, and it just highlights so much how vulnerable we all are. Do you think something will change as a result in terms of how we diversify the tech ecosystem, as you call it?
Well, hopefully something will change. I mean, I would be incredibly disappointed and we would be incredibly remiss if we continue to operate as though we never learned a lesson from this. If we learn one lesson, it's that if we need resiliency, we have to have diversity in our environment, diversity in operating systems, not just rely on any one vendor, be it Microsoft or CrowdStrike from a security perspective.
Why has it been like this though? I mean, for so long, right? And we're just figuring this out now after such a massive crash. I mean, just investors, or if you have a 401k, you're told by advisors to diversify your stocks just to minimize risk. You would think that that would apply in the tech world.
Well, it should apply in the tech world. We've known about these problems for a long time, for probably almost 20 years. This issue of diversity in the environment to increase resiliency has been known. But the bottom line is it requires investment, it requires effort, it requires work to diversify your environment and make sure that you're not susceptible to this. In this instance, we were looking at a mistake. You can bet that miscreants and takers are looking through this software, looking for problems which they can then deploy globally. So this issue, while a mistake this time, I think highlights a very serious flaw in how we do computing.
Before I get to how hackers are taking advantage of the situation, this hasn't fully been resolved. It's going to take time because, as I understand it, the computers will have to be manually, I guess, rebooted. How long is this going to take?
Well, it depends on people's staffing level, depends how remote some of these systems are. For a vast majority of infrastructure, it's going to take several hours or could take a matter of days. For very complex, large and distributed environments where there aren't people near their machines, it could literally take weeks and could cost tremendous amounts of money and effort to bring their systems online.
What about airlines and health systems?
Well, each environment is different, but we know yesterday there were almost 7,000 canceled flights. We know today already there are almost 2,000 canceled flights. So this is not an issue that's going to be with us forever, but it's not an issue that's going away in 10 hours or even 2 days.
So several days.
It will be several days.
Gotcha. So when we talk about risk to consumers, I mean, as our reporting has been from a Brian Fung, hackers are already taking advantage of the situation. They're sending out phony URLs in hopes, that some will click on them and they could breach their devices. Tell us what we as consumers need to be aware of right now.
Yeah, I think the best thing to do is rely on the IT staffs of the companies that you deal with. And those staffs need to go to CrowdStrike. We need to go to credible vendors to understand what's going on and how to restore their environments. Don't rely on inbound calls. Don't rely on emails and all the things which are known by scam artists to falsify information and gain advantage.
All right. We're going to leave it there. Thank you so much for your time, Amit Yoran.